And because Jesus wasn't just some prophet, mighty in word and deed, because Jesus is the Messiah who came to bring us new life that we might have it abundantly, Jesus calls us to a life that really is possible. Getting back to our movie, it is the Santa Anita race, and all the best horses are there. The prize to the winning horse is $100,000, which to us today would be right around $2 million. As the race is coming to an end, Seabiscuit seems to have a comfortable lead, and so Red Pollard lets up a little bit. He stops riding. Just as he does, another horse passes him on the right side. What we learn is that Red Pollard is blind in his right eye, and so he never saw the horse coming up his right side. He has kept this a secret his entire life because he was afraid that nobody would hire him. Tom is upset, the trainer, and he goes to Mr. Howard and he says, "He lied to us. He's blind in one eye. Do you want a jockey who lies to us?" Mr. Howard pauses for a moment, and then he looks at Tom and he says, "It's fine, Tom." Tom shouts back, "It's fine?" Mr. Howard walks over and he gently puts his hand on his shoulder and he says, "You don't throw a whole life away because it's just a little banged up." As our movie is coming to an end, Red says, "You know, everybody thinks we found this old broken down horse and fixed it, but we didn't. He fixed us, every one of us. And I guess in a way, we all fix each other." During Jesus' ministry on earth, Jesus sought those who were just a little banged up. He sought out the lost and the lonely. He sought out those who were physically and spiritually in pain. And he fixed them. He healed them. Not just by giving sight to the blind or making the lame to walk or cleansing the leper, but he healed them by touching the leper when nobody else would. By eating with the sinners while others condemned them. By kneeling with the woman caught in adultery while everyone else was ready to throw stones. He healed them by loving them when nobody else could. God became one of us because God wanted to reveal to us a new way of life. A way of life that is not focused on ourselves and on getting further and further ahead, but it is focused on our neighbor. It is focused on those who are in need. It is focused on those who are broken. A new way of life not about greed or hatred, but about forgiveness and love and compassion. On the road to Emmaus, the two urged Jesus, "Stay with us." And when they invited Jesus to come into their home, he opened their eyes to all the new possibilities so that they could know and so that they could live a better way of life. "Stay with us" is the moment before our eyes are open to the possibility of what God can and will do in this world through us. Let us pray. Merciful and mighty Lord, you come to us where we are. You come to those of us who are a little banged up. You love us as we are. You comfort us as we are. You heal us as we are. We promise that you will never leave our side. Amen.